So in today's video, as you can see, we're back in a bathroom, okay? And we've done previous videos within bathrooms and looking at the zones within bathrooms. But however, we have a difference today because we're actually standing in a wet room, okay? So we're gonna look at the difference within zones in a wet room to that previous that we've looked at in bathrooms. So we're here in the wet room down on the floor, okay? And we're looking at, first of all, zone zero. Now, we're used to there being either a bathtub or a shower tray, and we know that zone zero is inside of that area. However, we don't have a tray or a tub in this wet room. So zone zero is actually the floor itself, where we're gonna be standing in the water itself, okay? Now, the things we need to look at here is the outlet here. So what we're gonna actually look at is where zone one extends from this outlet. So before, where zone one would be from the edge of zone zero, okay? Now it's actually on the outlet, not necessarily straight off of the edge of zone zero. Okay, so when we measure zone one in this bathroom, okay, we're actually looking at a diameter of 1.2 meters from the center of this outlet here. So if I was to measure from the center of that outlet, okay, there to 1.2 meters, and you can see we've put a bit of tape here just to indicate where zone one lies. Now it's important to know that within this zone one, okay, this arc here, the floor everywhere inside of there is zone zero. The minute we pick our foot off of that floor, we enter into zone one of this wet room. So as you can see, we've got our tape here, okay, which follows all the way around where we've taken our 1.2 meter measurement from the center of this outlet. Now it's important to note this outlet here is in the corner, okay, which is quite common with wet rooms. However, it could be positioned in other places. If that was, let's say, in the center of the room here, we would have to take our 1.2 meter measurement and that would go all the way around this wet room, okay? The reason we've got the tape here is because naturally we have walls, so the 1.2 meters stops there and follows it round. So now we've sort of looked at the measurements on the floor with zone one and zone zero. We can look at the height again. Now we know the height from zone one and it extends to 2.25 meters. So that hasn't changed. And again, just to reiterate, if we had a fixed shower outlet head up here or maybe a waterfall head in the ceiling, zone one would actually extend to past that fixed outlet, okay? So just because there's one here doesn't mean zone one extends to here. It actually still extends to 2.25 meters in this wet room. Again, if it was fixed up there, it would extend past that point. So now we've looked at zone zero being the floor in this area, okay? And we've looked at zone one and the measurements we need to apply in a wet room. Now we need to talk about zone two. So what we're used to doing in a, let's say, a generic bathroom with a tub or a shower tray is zone two would extend 600 millimeters from the edge of zone one. So if I was to do this, okay? From the edge of zone one here, 600, you'd expect this area to be zone two. However, slightly different in wet rooms, zone two actually doesn't exist, okay? We do not have a zone two within this area. So again, just to cover, again, BS 1363 socket outlets within a bathroom, okay? Within a wet room, it is still 2.5 meters from the edge of zone one, okay? So in this wet room here, there's nowhere in here it could be because it's not of that size. But however, we do actually have one outside of this wet room, which is just here. And this actually falls within 2.5 meters of the edge of zone one. But again, as we talked about with our airing cupboards, once we come through this doorway, okay, and there is two doorways in this wet room, so it applies to both, we're actually no longer in a special location. Hence, rules for special locations no longer apply. So again, with IP ratings, just to reiterate, there's no difference to what we've already spoke about in previous videos, okay? So we're generally looking at IPX4 or IPX5 if there's water jets within this wet room here, okay? And all the IP ratings apply for the various zones. Now, the customer actually bought this off of eBay, okay? And they've asked me to fit it. Took it out of the box. First thing worried me was a plug, and his wet room isn't about 10 meters long. It's actually a hairdryer, okay? But the other thing that worried me about installing the bathroom is actually on the back, if you have a look, it talks about the waterproof rating is IPX1. So I've nicely explained to the customer why we cannot fit this in the wet room while we're here today. And he's fine with it. He's gonna look for another product that is maybe suitable for this area. So just to summarize really, okay? So within this wet room, things like IP ratings stay the same generally as the other bathrooms that we see on a day-to-day basis. Socket outlets, distances, again, stay the same in accordance with the edge of the zones. However, the main difference within this wet room is that outlet there, okay? And zone zero and zone one. Remember, zone zero is the floor itself where we're touching the water. Zone one extends a measurement of 1.2 meters from the outlet in the floor, regardless of where that is in the bathroom. And the big change obviously being no zone two in this bathroom or this wet room. So effectively from the edge of where zone one finishes, all of the area there is actually outside of the zones. So again, as always, we hope this video has been some help.